In this session, I'm going to teach you about adding and subtracting dissimilar fractions. Dissimilar fractions because in this case, we will be adding and subtracting fractions which do not have similar denominators. For example, here, we will add 79 plus 16. Okay, these fractions are dissimilar because their denominators are not the same, which are 9 and 6. Okay, to add these fractions, we have to do something. There is a step in doing this one because we cannot do it directly. Okay, in the rule, we have to make them similar first. To make them similar, you have to find their LCM. Okay. LCM or least common multiple, least common multiple of 9 and 6. So 9 and 6, which are the denominators. So for 9, for the multiples of 9, we have 9, we have 18, we have 27, and so on. Okay, it will not stop. Dami niyan. And then for the 6, we have 6, we have 12, we have 18, we have 24, and so on. There are a lot of them, unending. But as you can see, we will not go on because we can already see that there is 18 there. Okay, so the 18 here will now be our LCD. Okay, so LCD, meaning to say least common denominator. So we have here 18, which is the denominator. We will make a new fraction for this. Okay, so this is 79 will become this one, a new fraction. 18, listen, 18 divided by 9 equals 2. 2 times 7 equals 14. So 14 now is our new numerator. As you can see, 14 over 18 is equivalent to 79. So happened that this one is the higher term and this one is in the lower term or lowest term. Okay, but they are equal. They are equivalent fraction. Okay, for this case, 1/6, we will make it another fraction which is similar to this. 18 divided by 6 equals 3. Again, 18 divided by 6 equals 3. 3 times 1 equals 3. So this is now our new fraction for 1/6. So 1/6 and 3/18 are equivalent fractions. They are equal. This is in the higher term. This is in the lowest term. So we can now add. Why? Because their denominators are already the same. So the rule says we just have to add the numerators and copy the denominator, which is 18. So 14 plus 3 equals 17. So we have now the answer. And then look closely if this is in the simplest or lowest term or simplest form. 17 over 18. Okay, this is a prime number, meaning to say we have nothing to do with this. This is already the simplest form. So this is the final answer already. No need to reduce it to its lowest term. Yay! Okay, so that's it. How to add fractions that are dissimilar? Simply find their LCM so that you can have their LCD, so that you can make them similar. Because unless these fractions become similar, you cannot add them. That's it. So let's proceed now to subtraction. How do we subtract fractions that are dissimilar? Okay, we will use the same fractions here. 79 minus 1/6. Okay, so again, we cannot subtract these fractions if they are not the same. So the LCM here, we already have this, which is 18. So we will just copy 18, and then 18 here, which is our denominator. Just a sort of review how we find this 14 and 3. 18 divided by 9 equals 2. 2 times 7 equals 14. 18 divided by 6 equals 3. 3 times 1 equals 3. Now, we can already subtract the numerators. 14 minus 3 equals 11. And then, just copy the denominator, which is 18. And there you have it. This is now your answer. Okay, so this is now the difference. 11 over 18. And then, look closely. Is this in the simplified form? Is this already in the lowest term? As you can see, 11 is a prime number, meaning to say this is already final and cannot be reduced to its lowest term already. Yay! This is the final answer. Okay, that's it. That's how we add and subtract fractions that are not the same or not similar. Okay, just consider finding the LCM so that you can make them similar. And when they are similar already, it's very easy. You can do it very smoothly. And the last thing that I have to remind you, see to it that your final answer should be in the simplest form. That's it.